to April. This video is for your sun sign. And while you can use it for any part of your chart, this video right here is going to tell you why it is for your sun sign and then how you should also be using, you know, your rising sign, your moon sign to navigate different things like the love video right here that's going to be coming out pretty soon, as well as the career video over here that you can be looking forward to. And so if you want to catch those, make sure that you're subscribed and you hit the notification bell, and let's get started. This month, we're going to look at the general theme, the beginning, middle, and end of the month, what's going to be going super well for you this month, what's your biggest challenge going to be, what you should be avoiding this month, and then the best way to use this month to your advantage, as well as finding out what your crystal of the month is. The decks that I'm using today are the Cosmic Tribe Tarot and the Fuck It deck. If you want information on those, I do have affiliate links in the bottom because a bitch has to get paid. Okay, here we go. Hey, Scorpio. So the general theme for your month is the Queen of Swords. I've been thinking about the Queen of Swords a lot lately. You know, she's very much like, hey, I am fair. People might think that I'm harsh, but I'm not. Like, I give you a chance, and if you fuck it up, sure, I'll kill you. But I am fair, I am just, I am wise, I'm experienced. So that's kind of a cool energy to have. I guess it's kind of typical Scorpio, though. So beginning of the month, what does it look like for you? What they're saying is the details aren't really important. Think in broad strokes, not like the tiny little things. In the middle of the month, which isn't different from Capricorn, actually. In the middle of the month, then this is something that all the signs have had so far. It's like all of a sudden, it's hard to communicate with other people. I don't know if you're just like not in the mood, if it's hard to get a hold of people, you're not texting as much, you're not calling as much, you're kind of shutting yourself down, or you're not getting what you want to say across very well. And they're saying, though, this isn't something really super within your control, so don't let it make you feel too uncomfortable. Going to the end of the month, what is kind of happening for you here? And they're saying, you know, this might not be the perfect time for you to like really indulge in spoiling yourself, doing some online shopping for that handbag you always wanted or something like that. But you already know that, you're already aware. It's the thing that's really kind of hard is it's like knowing where and how to give of your time, your energy, your love, your resources. All of a sudden you have to kind of scale that back a little bit and think more critically about it. You know, who deserves my time, my energy, my love, my care, my support, my assistance? And being more discerning with that instead of so open and kind and generous in that way. So what's going to be going super well for you this month? And what they say is, well, okay, it's not exactly what you're hoping for. So what is it then? They're like, we can't tell you, actually, because something has to go not so well. Something kind of has to come apart for something new and better and more beautiful to be built in its place. And they're saying, you know, it's something different than you've ever experienced before. And so if we were to tell you right now, you wouldn't feel like it's very magical. You wouldn't feel super good about it. And this is why we don't tell you. You know, it's not that they don't know. It's not that they can't tell you. But it's that because you wouldn't like it until you have it. Right? And so sometimes then we resist things that are good for us and we push them away energetically instead of having open arms to receive it. And so they're saying it's not something that you're manifesting. It's not something that you even think that you want. It's not even something that you think will bring you joy, but it will. And so this month might be a little bit challenging. A couple things going on that you weren't super thrilled about, but end up to be huge blessings for you later. Now, what is the biggest challenge going to be for you? And they're saying to feel confident, to really kind of stand in your own and feel good about it and about the direction you're heading in when you're heading in a direction that you never even knew you wanted. It makes me think of that Neo song, you're the best thing I never knew I needed, right? It's that. It's like, oh, okay, oh, fuck, I don't want a kid. Like, I'm too young for this. I don't have the resources. Like, and then all of a sudden, it's the best thing that ever happened in your life. I think that's what it was written for his daughter or something like that. But, I mean, these kinds of things happen all the time. The best things that happen to us often felt like the worst thing that could have happened to us when they happened. So anyway, What is it that you should be avoiding this month, my darling Scorpios? It looks like a couple of things, so I'm going to pull a couple of cards because half the deck was just like, let's have a chat. So they're saying certain people in your life are proof that you cannot polish a turd. As much as we want people to change, as much as we want people to grow and be the best versions of themselves, sometimes they don't want to do that, and we have to accept that and just move on. So we should be avoiding those people. Now, wealth is on its way to you, and so this is why they don't want to tell you certain things about your month, right? They don't want you to fuck it up for yourself, because maybe an opportunity comes that you didn't even think you'd be interested in, but then all of a sudden when you take it, you're like, oh my God, love it. So I'm really excited for these money and career videos to come out for you. So make sure you're subscribed so that when those do come out, you're alerted. Okay, and then what is the best way to use this month to your advantage, my darling Scorpios? They're like taking action, getting excited, getting pumped up, getting enthusiastic, and just kind of being spontaneous and going with the flow, following your passion and your whims, really. And because those are going to lead to really good things. Now, here is an article about your power crystal of the month if you're interested in what that can help you do and help you to cope with the month ahead. And I will otherwise see you in May.